rig control system. It's all mounted on a piece of polycarb, and it has an LCD screen, so you can see the boot up status. And now I'm going to make a circuit board for this as well that'll go on the Arduino shield. So that's the next step. Okay, this is the ROV side electronics. It has my custom circuit board where you just plug in the servo leads and they go straight to your motor controllers. The motor. Previously, I had limited the control sticks so it only pulled 2 amps forward and reverse. Those are now removed, so it's the full range. Could go up to 10 amps. Okay, so the LCD screen will show the boot up status once the power's connected. So initializing PS2 connected, ROV disabled, and it flashes fast, 10 hertz. So once you hit enable on or start on the PS2 controller, slowly, and LCD will change to ROV enabled. So when you power this up, so first of all, there you heard the motor and ESC boot up, so those are ready to go. The Arduino board is now ready. It's got its fast blinking light, so as soon as the top side is enabled, the bottom side will go as well. And the Hobby King current meter will display the voltage as well as the minimum and maximum that we see as we pull current into the motor. Okay, hit the start button. Okay, so ROV is enabled. And now, let's just slowly ramp up to 100%. Okay, so that's the full range of the joystick. Quite a bit of power, more than I'll ever need. That's why I'm limiting it. Okay, now you want to go reverse. So now we're changing to reverse. This is the optimal direction for the propeller. This is how it's designed. Little over 8 amps, and we're down to about 11.1, which is a standard LiPo. Water that's moving. That's more than we'll ever need if I have 2 of these on there.